Hello, what we're working on is a 2004 Chevy or GMC 1500. As you can see, this is a crew cab. I'm going to show you some tricks to getting the torsion key out without cutting the cross member, which a lot of videos show cutting the cross member. I don't think that's a smart move. No heat and not a big hammer. I did this not too long ago with an extended cab. This is a crew cab, and the problem with the crew cab is there's an additional cross member about 6 inches behind the cross member that supports the torsion keys. So you can't get a drift and a hammer in there. You cannot strike the end of the torsion key very hard just because of the extra stuff that's in there. So I'll show you some tricks to getting it out. So this is the torsion key on the driver's side. I've already got out. As you can see, I haven't put the passenger side one in yet. And all I did was drilled 3 holes. My camera really sucks. So I drilled 3 holes in it. And then took this cold chisel and I put it in there and I spanked it in there pretty hard. And cracked, you can't see it, but I basically cracked the torsion key. This is the hammer I used. So you don't need a big hammer. You don't need a lot of force. It's really not that hard to do if you take your time and do it smart. And as you can see, the only difference in the two torsion keys is it's slightly index different. So what I'll do is I'll show you how I got that out with minimal effort in about an hour and about a half a bottle of Irish whiskey. So the first thing I suggest you do is do the shock extension, or at very least pull the bottom shock bolt out. I know everybody wants to do the torsion key and get working on that right away, but in all reality, you don't, it's really hard to put enough preload on the new torsion key to get the keeper. I'm going to call it the keeper, but the piece that holds the bolt in that torques up the torsion key. So pull the tire off. If you don't have one of these things, this is a M18 Milwaukee half inch impact gun. This is the only tool that I have that I would without hesitation replace it if it got broken or stolen. That is the best tool that I've ever owned. I have a 2007 Kenworth gravel truck, and this pulls the lug nuts off that. This is the best tool that I've ever owned, and I say without a doubt, without hesitation, go buy one of these. It's about $600 in Canada. It's $600. I don't know what it is American. That is the best tool you can buy. As you can see, I've used it a bit. It's worth every penny. So what we're doing here is the pulling the shock bolt out. So the reason we're pulling this out is it gives you more travel on the lower A-arm. You pull this out before you do anything else. You got to do it anyways. You might as well get out of the way. As you can see, I've already put some PB Blaster on the torsion key that goes into the A-arm. I did that about, I don't know, 8 hours ago. That kind of helps out the process. So pull this bolt out first. So as you can see, I pulled that bolt out. I'll just leave that loose. This thing is pressurized, so you got to physically pull it up. But the point being is it won't go down any farther. So that's out. And we'll allow that lower control arm to move around. So I already took this out. You don't need a tutorial on how to remove one bolt. I used the Milwaukee Impact, zinged this out. And then there's a special tool you can get. I just use this puller. The puller is actually small, but I'm too drunk to drive over to my other shop where I have a bigger puller. I just use this to take a little bit of the preload out and get that keeper, or whatever the heck you want to call it, out of that little half moon thing. This was the cross member I was talking about. So the regular cabs and the extended cabs don't have this, and you can hit the end of the torsion rod pretty hard with a drift or a hammer or whatever you want. But this is only about 6 inches. You don't have as much room to work here, and that's why I pissed around with it and figured out a better way to pull this key out. This is a Canadian truck. It's got 360,000 kilometers, so it's about 180,000-200,000 miles. It's rusty. It's by no means a new truck. And even though it's kind of rusted in there, I'll be able to get that torsion key out without any heat, without hitting it with a big hammer, and really honestly without a lot of screwing around. So the first thing I'll do is take another sip of whiskey. This is Irish whiskey. I'm a big Chris Stapleton fan. He talks about Tennessee whiskey. I'm sure it's great. But I drink a lot of Irish whiskey. So what we're going to do, what's going on here is this torsion bar is already loaded. It's been loaded and torqued on by the A-arm. And it's no different than a socket on an old worn out nut or bolt. And you put a bunch of torque on it and it's bound up. And the only way to get it off is to back the socket off. That's all we're going to do. We're going to try to twist this torsion rod in the opposite direction that it's loaded up. In addition to that, the torsion key has got the same thing going on. You can't really see it because it's behind this cross member, but it's all bound up as well. First thing we're gonna do is drill a hole in the spot where the bolt that holds the torque on the torsion key presses in, and we're going to use it in the opposite direction and pull on it. Now, it seems like a lot of fucking around, but it's actually not a big deal. It's just a drill. I got a 1/8 bit, and then I'll put another one on there, about a 3/8 bit. We're going to put a bolt in there and a piece of flat bar. We're going to pull this down, and it's going to clunk and back out and unload that torsion bar. So that's the 1/8 pilot hole. And I'm about to drill about a 3/8 hole for the bolt. So I've drilled a hole in this torsion key. It's about 3/8. Like I said, I'm in Canada, so we use metric. I don't know what size metric this is, but it's about a 3/8 hole. And all we're trying to do is pull down on this end of the torsion key. And I'll have a little jig here I'll show you in a second. It's going to pull down on this. So what we got here is, you can see this key, the torsion key. I have a bolt going through it. This is about a 1/2 inch piece of half by a 2 inch flat bar I had laying around, drilled a hole in it. This is my backup wrench on the nut on the other side of that. What I'm gonna do is tighten this up, and it's gonna put a backwards force on that torsion key. This little puller I made, I'll tighten that up, and you won't see it because it's hard to hold the camera, but it makes a little clunk, and that key unloads, and it's loose inside of that control arm. So we use this puller. It's just a piece of flat bar with a hole drilled in it. I pulled down on this torsion key. Now, the torsion bar is still tight on the torsion key, whatever you want to call this, but it is loose now. It goes into the A-arm. I'm just using my hand. I couldn't do that before. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna drill some holes in this right on the corner of that keyway. We're gonna drill a few holes in here. We're going to section it. We're going to cut it without cutting the cross member with a zip disc. And then we're going to put a cold chisel in there and we're going to split this. And it sounds like a lot of work, but I'll have it done in about 15 minutes, maybe a little less. And this is just going to fall out. It's a piece of cake. So I just finished drilling 3 pilot holes. As you can see, I kind of half-assed lined them up at the corner of the torsion key. You know, I didn't spend any time with center punches or measuring them, just kind of eyeballing it a bit, and now I'll drill it out with a bigger bit. So I drilled those out. I think it's a quarter inch drill bit. It's not pretty, but it doesn't really matter too much. The next thing I'll do after this is I'll take the zip disc and I'll just cut this until the zip disc is almost cutting the cross member, but it won't nick it. And then the cold chisel will do the rest. So I cut that with the zip disc. I did just scrape this tiny bit. Not too worried about that. Now I'm going to drive a cold chisel right in there. So I drove this chisel into here. This is the only hammer I've used. So you don't need a big hammer. You don't have to cut the cross member out. You don't have to put any heat on this whatsoever. And I know it's loose because I've been pissing around with it. You can see it's kind of loose. I'll just shake that out. And that torsion key's out. So I'm installing the new torsion key. Instead of buying that tool, or renting the tool, or getting the tool, whatever you want to call it, I just use a puller, a gear puller. This is a really cheap, this is too small actually for this. When I put this on, I'm a little weary because you put a little crank on it, and you actually bend this a tiny little bit, but you can get it with this. I would use a bigger puller, but I drank about a 3/4 of a bottle of whiskey by now, and I'm not going to drive to my other shop to get a bigger puller. Just going to use the one I got. And this works really good. Doesn't cost anything if you got a puller in your toolbox. So this is the key that's going to go in. You saw the puller on there. Now, you got to put so much torque on it that you'll bend that flange that I showed a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grind the scale off of this, and I'm also going to round these edges a little bit so they're a little bit more round. Reason being is you have to put a lot of force on that puller in order to get this in there. So you want to clean this all off and give yourself a little bit more tolerance to get that in there. You have to put an uncomfortable amount of force on that little puller in order to get this in there. So I cleaned this keeper up. I just got the scale and a little bit of rust off the back of it. And then ground this so it's a little bit more clean. Side you can see it's really proud and it's got these kind of ridges on it. This side is a little smoother now. It just makes putting this in a little easier, that's all. I'm about to preload, I guess, this torsion rod with this gear puller. I'm gonna put in the keeper that we talked about that I ground kind of clean. And in the beginning of the video, I talked about pulling the shock bolt out. I'm gonna try to do this with one hand, but I'm tightening up this torsion key, and you can see that lower A-arm moving farther and farther away from the shock strut. And if you don't, sorry about the camera, the phone being shaky, but if you don't unbolt that shock holds the lower A-arm in place, and it doesn't give you enough movement on this key to get that keeper in. So you have to unbolt that. See how much that's moving? It's moved almost, over half an inch, 5/8, maybe 3/4 of an inch. And I'll put enough torque on it that, I'm gonna stick my finger in there, but that keyway will lift up inside of this hole, and I can slide that keeper in there. Tighten that puller up a bunch. Enough that key, keeper will go in there. So So I pulled off the gear puller. Now I'm setting the, doing the setup on this bolt, which kind of preloads the torsion key. And all this is a drill bit. It doesn't really matter what you use. As you can see, this is in there quite a ways. So I have a little bit more on here than I want. And I'm just going to use this as a feeler gauge. So I put this, I'm putting the end of this in there. It's a little loose. Tighten it up a little bit. There, now it's snug. So this is the same drill bit that I used on the other side. I'm going to go, what I'm going to do is I'm going to let the truck down and do my final adjustments by backing these out rather than trying to tighten them up. That's all. So to recap, I did have to cut the cross member. I didn't even use any heat on the old torsion key. I just drilled a few holes in it, split it. Thing got quite loose. Used that puller to back it off. And it's taken me a little time to do the video, but really I could have done this in an hour and a half. I haven't done the back, obviously. This is just the front, but I'm pretty much done. That's about it. Hope this helps. Like I said, I've done a few of these. This is the crew cab, so it has this extra cross member on it. So you can't really hit this thing, and that's why I did this extra work to try to figure out how to put these torsion keys off without hitting the end of this thing. Anyways, take care. Good luck. Bye.